x to the power x times square root of x is equal to x times square root of x to the power of x. Find the value of x. At this moment, I encourage you to pause the video and solve it by yourself. I will try to solve it now. At first, it's good to look at this question and think about the domain. What is possible? Because we want to solve this question for real numbers. So I'll start from domain. Domain will be x's. I have square root. Because of square root, I would have x more or equal to 0. And also, when x is 0, I can see on both sides, I would just have 0 to the power of 0, which really we don't know what's that. It's undefined. We cannot calculate 0 to the power of 0. So x has to be positive, just positive, because it cannot be 0. So domain, x is more than 0. Now, I will start slowly. I will copy left side x to the power x square root of x, and very slowly I will start simplifying right side. x to the power of 1. Square root of x is just x to the power of 1/2. And this all I have to the power of x. I will just copy left side. X to the power x square root of x is equal to, on the right side, I will use properties of product of powers. The same base, so I add powers. So I have x 1 plus 1/2 straight away is 3 over 2 to the power of x. I go down. Then I will copy left side, x to the x square root of x is equal to x to the power of powers, x to the power and everything to power, so I multiply powers, 3 over 2 times x, so 3 over 2x. Then I can see I have the same base. Base is x, so left side is equal to right side when exponents are equal, so I will write x square root of x is equal to 3 over 2x. Now, I want to look at the domain. I remember domain was x's which are positive. If I know x is not 0, this is equation, so I'll just divide both sides by x. X divided by x will be just 1. 1 times square root of x, so on the left side, when I divide by x, I'll just have square root of x. And on the right side, I'll just have 3 over 2. So I have square root of x equals to 3 over 2. I want to calculate x, so I have square root of x. I will square both sides. When I square both sides, I'll have square root of x squared will be just x. And 3 over 2 squared will be 3 squared is 9, and 2 squared is 4. And I have the answer. And actually, question is almost done. But it's easy to miss something in this question. Let's say I could talk about this step here. When I've written just exponents. I've written just exponent is equal to exponent. Maybe it's easy to forget about something. Because when x is 1 and I can see that x is in my base, what's 1 to power of anything? 1 to power of anything is just 1. So I don't even care about exponents. I have x on the left here and x on the right here. 1, if x is 1, 1 to the power of anything, on the left side actually, this will be 1 to the power of 1 times 1. So 1 to the power of 1 anyway, 1 to anything is 1. So left side here when x is 1, left side is 1, and right side here, x is 1, let's say x is 1, 3 over 2 times 1 is 3 over 2, 1 to power of 3 over 2 is the same as 1. I could consider that 1 even at the beginning of the question. Here, when x is 1, or even here, when x is 1, 1 to the power of 1 times 1, because square root of 1 is 1, that's 1, this is 1. And when x is 1, x is 1 times square root of 1, 1, 1 times 1, 1 to the power of x, which is 1. So x equals 1 is also the solution. It was easy to miss it. We need to be careful when we have base equal to x. So we have two answers. X is 9 over 4, but also x is equal to 1. Two answers.